This is a very brief video photo history of the Cleggs and where they came from. The Cleggs originated from northern England, an area in Lancashire County in the town of Oldham. It was there that Benjamin Sr. denounced the Church of England, joined the LDS Church, and moved to America. When he came to America, he settled in Utah in Tooele, which is south of the Great Salt Lake. And there in Tooele, his son Peter and the family started to establish themselves as sheep farmers, and his brother Benjamin. Benjamin left and moved to Idaho and started a family and was soon called on a mission to Australia. While he was on a mission in Australia, it was here that shortly after he left, his son Donald Willard was born, and he was born at the old Williams homestead down in Cleveland. This is a picture in front of the house that Grandpa Donald Clegg was born in. It was taken in 1973, and it is was up on the hill above the what is now known as the Williams House. The Williams House is on the highway as you come into the valley, and it was built out of bricks made by hand by the family members. Uncle Will, who was Grandpa's uncle, came and told how he used to do that as a small boy. Grandpa Benjamin established his home in the Bench area and lived in an older cabin that they built there on the corner of in Bench. It was in this house that he raised his family. And this is a sketching of what the house looked like, the old Clegg homestead, which was on the southwest corner. This is a photograph of Benjamin and his family. And this is the corners area in Bench. On each of the corners, his sons eventually built homes. So Joseph, Robert, and Orson. Donald and Lucille made their home just not too far away. And in what is the current homestead. The home that was on the property was originally built by Charlie Hubbard in the 1890s, and this is a picture in the 1920s, I believe, of the home with Benjamin and his family, and a picture of a barn that was built to replace the barn that burned down. But these are aerial photos of the current home. Some of the other properties that Grandpa Clegg, Grandpa Don, ran included the Well property. I believe it was originally called maybe the Cackley Place, but a well was dug there, and irrigation water was pumped to produce better crops. And this is a view of that property today. Every good Clegg piece of property has a junkyard, and this is what it looks like. The well, north of the well property was another property called the Whitehead Place, and that was dry farm. And then north of that, again, was a place that was called, I believe, the Gregoire Place. It was owned by Val Jean Andreessen. These are some aerial shots of those pieces of property today. And other property that Grandpa ran was the airport area north of Grace. There was property on the east side and the west side of the road. And thanks to my dad and his flight instructor, that became a place for the Grace Airport. As he was finished up learning to fly and they were looking for a place to put an airport, Grandpa had just purchased the property and they decided to put the Grace Airport there. These are a few shots of the property today. Other property that Grandpa ran included the Nolan Ranch. This was out north of Soda Springs on the way to Blackfoot Reservoir. Uncle David and his family lived here for several years. And this was a property that Grandpa purchased from A.J. Nolan, who was a big sheep rancher. Had the river runs through the property, and there was a lot of development work for irrigation there as well. These are shots of the property today. From the Nolan Ranch, there was Rasmussen Valley, which was primarily a summer cattle range. We would drive the cattle on foot from the Grace up to the airport and then on out to Soda and to the Nolan Ranch and then eventually to Rasmussen Valley for the summer. These are again shots today. And another piece of property included Gray's Lake. Grandpa Donald Clegg and all of his brothers had property out here, and I believe Uncle Peter Clegg, great-grandfather Benjamin's brother, had property out here as well. This is what Gray's Lake looks like. It's more of a marsh, but looking north. This is an area showing the corrals and where they would keep the cattle. And these are just different shots of the property. Caribou Mountain above the lake, and you can see from the property. This was looking down where there was an old cabin right there. And these are a few shots looking out over the valley. And from the air back on the hill of the mountains and back up over towards Clark Canyon.